An accused Capitol rioter has been ordered back to jail as he awaits trial for 7 different federal charges because he has allegedly been tampering with one of the witnesses who is set to testify against him. And that witness just happens to be his estranged wife who stormed the Capitol with him. So, you know, great place to have a date night, I guess. What do you want to do today, sweetheart? I don't know. Why don't we go storm the Capitol together? And then I guess the relationship fell apart after that. Or maybe it was already falling apart before it, and maybe they thought this would rekindle the romance like some kind of, you know, perverted version of a Hallmark movie. But whatever it is, it didn't work. The couple split. They're still married, but they're separated and estranged, and she was set to testify against him in the trial. Until, of course, prosecutors said that he sent thousands of text messages to her, effectively threatening and harassing her about what could happen if she testified against him. And, of course, he advised her, you need to try to claim spousal privilege. But let me read this from the prosecutors here. Norwood's messages to his estranged wife are harassing, abusive, petulant, and occasionally threatening. Abusive, occasionally threatening, right? Every now and then, maybe a little threat tossed in here and there. Petulant. But here's the thing, folks. These idiots keep getting caught. And that's what I love about all these stories about the Capitol rioters. They keep getting caught for everything they do because they're very stupid people. I mean, let's be real clear about that. We don't have to dance around it. We don't have to soften our language when talking about these criminals. You know, the ones who've been convicted, of course. If you have not been convicted, you are not technically a criminal. But all of them as a whole are just very stupid. I've been paying very close attention to the plea dealings, to the sentencing. These are people who absolutely just are so lucky they have talented lawyers. Because if they didn't, if all of these cases went to trial, these people are so bad at this, they probably, every single one of them would have been convicted. Like, that's how bad they are. And this guy, I'm not going to name his name, but, you know, sending thousands of messages to his wife, effectively what amounts to witness tampering, thinking like, oh, I'm getting out of this. You're texting her. Folks, I want you to be clear. If you text somebody something, make sure it's something that you're comfortable having read back to you in court, because that's the state we're in today. And yes, that is terrifying to have to think about that, but that's where we are. So be careful what you text. And if you're going to commit a crime, please don't text it. Please don't commit crimes anyway, but, you know, things like witness tampering, don't do those ever, but definitely don't do them over text messages, because that's not private. Nothing's private anymore, which is a shame in and of itself. But again, it's laughable, because these people keep getting caught. They got caught in the riot. They got caught because they posted their own videos. They got caught because they boasted about it. They got caught because they, you know, took items home with them. Actually, this particular guy had a cop's riot shield and helmet in his garage at home. It was like, oh yeah, I picked it up from a pile outside the Capitol as we were leaving. Like, it was just like, oh cool, souvenirs. Like, no, those aren't like the mouse ears you get at Disney World. Those belong to the police officers. So that's, you know, stolen property. So again, we're talking about some of the dumbest people in this country that actually, unfortunately, came a hair's breadth away from basically overthrowing the government. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.